Hi everyone, welcome to FinTech Academy. This is Hirsch. Today I will go over the Canadian Income Tax T2 topic about understanding GIFI codes and financial statements. All right, let's have a look what we'll be covering in this particular topic. First of all, we'll be going through understanding GIFI codes, how to allocate GIFI codes, what statements will the GIFI codes be applicable to, and then I'll be showing a sample of Schedule 100 and Schedule 125. All right, understanding GIFI codes. The General Index of Financial Information, GIFI, is a system which assigns a unique code to a list of items commonly found on businesses' income statements, balance sheets, and statement of retained earnings. The listing was created by the Canada Revenue Agency, CRA, in 1999. The GIFI, General Index of Financial Information, literally is a set of codes that identify and organize the financial statement information of your corporation. It corresponds to a chart of accounts, which in accounting defines and organizes a business's finances. In a simple chart of accounts, all the asset accounts, for instance, might be numbered in the 1000s. So cash, accounts receivables, and prepaid expenses would all have 1000 numbers assigned to them to show that they are all asset accounts, such as. So basically, an example is asset. All they start with number one when I say 1000. So we can say 1000 is for cash and deposits. Example 1001, which is cash, bank drafts, bank notes, checks, coins, currency, money orders, postal notes, and post-dated checks. 1002 is deposits in Canadian banks and institutions in the Canadian currency. 1003 is deposits in Canadian banks and institutions foreign currency. All corporations except for insurance corporations should prepare their financial statement information using the GIFI codes and file it with their T2 returns. The purpose of the GIFI is to allow the CRA to collect and process financial information more efficiently. For instance, the GIFI lets the CRA validate tax information electronically rather than manually. Information from financial statements is categorized under the appropriate GIFI code and entered on corporate income tax returns. If you file a T2 income tax return, the tax return for corporations, then you need to use the GIFI, choosing the GIFI codes that best matches the items that you report. All right, let's have a look at the next part, which is how to allocate GIFI codes. The GIFI consists of items you find on a balance sheet and on an income statement. The balance sheet section consists of items pertaining to assets, liabilities, and equity for corporations or partners' capital for partnerships. Items specific to retained earnings for corporations are included in this area as well. The income statement section consists of items you find under revenue, cost of sales, and expenses. Appendix A of Guide RC4088 provides complete details of the GIFI codes. If you are manually working through your T2 return, the basic process is to take your corporation's financial documents, such as your balance sheet, and match the items on your financial statements to the corresponding GIFI code. If you have been using accounting software, it'll make it easier to link your accounts to GIFI codes, and therefore your financial information are already organized by codes, just waiting in a sense to be transferred into your T2 corporate income tax return. Now, we do run a course on income tax T2, and in that we do cover this topic, that how to link or how to assign the tax line mapping in the accounting software, which we show in QuickBooks, and we also show the whole process that how you can export from QuickBooks and import in the software, which we show it in profile with this whole process getting done, so that you know if your numbers are ready in your QuickBooks, then they can directly be transferred over here in the software. So it is one of the important steps to assign the JFIC codes in the accounting software itself. And if you do that, then yes, things can become a little bit easy over there. Basically, all you are doing is matching your chart of accounts to the JFIC code that the Canada Revenue Agency uses. Combining accounting and tax preparation software can make using the JFIC faster and easier. All right, so let's have a look what statements will the JFIC codes be applicable. Primarily, the most valuable and the ones which are for every organization are the Schedule 100, which is balance sheet, and the Schedule 125, which is income statement. So first of all, Schedule 100, balance sheet. In Schedule 100, there are many schedules in which the JFIC items are grouped according to the different sections that appear in the balance sheet. Current assets, capital assets, intangible assets, etc. For example, Schedule 1599 contains JFIC items 1000 to 1599 that may be included in the balance sheet's current assets. So that's the Schedule 100, which is the balance sheet. Next is Schedule 125, which is income statement. Schedule 125 is a multiple copy form. The first copy of Schedule 125 relates to the principal business activity of the corporation, while the remaining copies allows you to produce supplementary copies of Schedule 125 for situations where the corporation has more than one line of business. So these two are the primary ones and mostly used in every organization. The next two, which is Schedule 101, that is when opening balance sheet is there. If you are preparing the return for a newly formed corporation, you must complete an opening balance sheet. Schedule 101 allows you to complete this information by providing access to the same JFIC items and the same schedule as Schedule 100, which is for the balance sheet. And then you have the Schedule 141 notes checklist. The notes checklist provides the CRA with information concerning the individuals that prepared the corporation's financial statements. They also indicate if there are notes to the financial statements and the kind of information that they contain. So these are the four statements, schedules, in fact, on which the JFIC codes are applicable. But the ones which are used most often are the first two, Schedule 100 and 125. When we learn in the course about the income tax T2, I go in a little bit detail of this Schedule 141, which is about the notes checklist and what is it. All those things get covered and explained why that schedule all is also equally important. But primarily, let's look at a sample of this Schedule 100 balance sheet and 125, which is the income statement. All right, so this is the sample Schedule 100 balance sheet summary. If you look right at the top, it starts with cash and deposits. 1000 is the code, and the balance is shown is 250,000. Then we have the cash, which is 1001 as a code, $4,000. Accounts receivable, 1060 is the JFIC code for that, which is 200,000. Inventory, parts and supplies is 1122. That's the JFIC code, $90,000. So basically, you either if you're doing the software, you click on the drop down and you select it from there. And if someone says, how do I get the list of the JFIC codes, which one is applicable? Well, CRA has already prepared that list on their website. You just type in JFIC codes and you will be able to get the whole list, just in case if you want to refer. Computer equipment / software, 1774. In this example, it is 35,900. Buildings, 360,000. Motor vehicles, 1742 is $50,000. So the total assets, what it shows over here is 2599. That's the code for that, and it is 989,900. So that's the part about the assets over here. Let's look at the liabilities. One thing which we saw, everything is common in assets. They all begin with number one. The same thing over here. Let's look at the liabilities and find out. Right, so in the liabilities, we have bank overdraft, which there is a Jiffy code 2600. There is nothing over here, zero amounts payable and accrued liabilities. So that is money to be paid, like accounts payable, which is 2620, 150,000. Loans from Canadian banks, 2701, 155,000. Due to shareholders slash directors, current amount 2780, $90,000. Then credit card loans, which is 2707, 30,000. Mortgages, which is 3141, 150,000. And taxes payable is the 2680, 52,500. Total liabilities is $627,500 over here. The next is the equity part in this Schedule 100, and that shows general reserve is 3543,200,000 in this example over here. Then there is retained earnings slash deficit, but in this case it's earnings. The code is 3600, 162,400, and if there is an equity, yes, 3620, which is the code 3362,400. So of course, liabilities plus owner's equity or the equity account is 989,900. That's how it will go ahead and match up. And we know that the fundamental bookkeeping equation is assets equal to liabilities plus equity. Right, guys, let's have a look at the next one, which is a sample of Schedule 125 income statement summary over here. So starting with on the top, what we have is the trade sales of goods and services, which is a revenue section. Code is 8,000 and the amount is $950,000 over here. Then we have the cost of sales. So first, starting with opening inventory, 8,300 or 8,300, that's a code of 140,000. Direct wages, 8340 is 198,270. Purchases slash cost of material, which is 8320, is 230,000. Closing inventory, 8500 with a $50,000. That's the amount which is the negative side. Cost of sales, which is 8518, is 518270. The gross profit on line number 8519 is 431,730. Then comes the operating expenses. All the list of different operating expenses with their codes are listed over here. The total of the operating expenses, which is in the code 9367, is 269,330. Generally, operating expenses is most of the times the largest section in any of these statements, right? And you guys can study on that part with the codes which are over here. Total expenses, which is 787,600, that is 518,270 plus 269,330 will get you that. And lastly, the net income, which is 9369, that's a code is 162,400. So we had a look at these statements with the codes. Now, you know, these codes will depend on any of these statements, what you pick it up. It could be more than one code making sense as well, so you are the best on that. For example, mortgages is 3141 if it's a long term, but there could be another code as well for mortgages if it's a current liability. So you will see something like this here when you prepare the statements, whichever is applicable for your corporation or for your business, that's what you should go ahead and pick it up on that. Alright guys, so hopefully you found this video helpful. Please like our video and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Also, let me know in comments what would you like to see in future videos, i.e. Harsh, I want to see this video, or Harsh, can you make video on this topic for accounting and bookkeeping, QuickBooks Desktop, QuickBooks Online, Microsoft Excel, Canadian Income Tax T1, Canadian Income Tax T2, or Canadian Payroll. Alternatively, you can also visit us at fintechsolutions.ca for our courses. Thanks for watching.